Hey guys, Justin Bryan here from selfmadesuccess.com, and in this video I want to give you 10 Instagram marketing strategies for your business to help you get more traffic to your website, to help you get more customers, to help you keep your customers around, to get more engagement, get more social media followers, all of the above. And the first thing I want to show you on Instagram is you should post at the right times. So timing is everything on social media. There are a lot more people on at certain times of the day, depending on the social media platform you're on. And in this case, Instagram has the best post time at 8 to 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And that is the best time to post. That's when you'll probably get the most engagement. Other than that, don't post between 3 and 4 p.m. because that's when you'll probably have a dip in engagement. So if you're going to post, you know, one or two times a day, don't waste it by posting at the wrong time. Post it at the prime time slots for Instagram. And if you're not going to post at any of those times, or you're going to post again, then just focus on posting outside of business hours. So maybe early in the morning or in the late afternoon to evening, that would be a good time to post. Post videos around 9 p.m. Eastern time. That's a great time to post videos. In fact, a study showed that they get about 34% more engagement at that time for whatever reason. And Sundays tend to have very low engagement, the lowest engagement of any day of the week for Instagram. So you might, if you're going to take a day off from Instagram, that would be the day. And Mondays and Thursdays are the best days to post. So if you're going to post something really important, those are the days you want to do it. Number two, you want to follow people who follow brands like yours. If you're trying to build up your fan base initially and you just need to get some followers to kind of get going, one great way to do that is you can follow people that you know would probably be interested in your brand. And about 10 to 20% of them are likely to follow you back. And it's kind of like Twitter, so it's probably about the same rate as Twitter. You know, when you follow people, some of them always follow you back. And there's a couple apps you can actually use to manage your followers and to keep track of them. And you can use Followers Plus for Instagram or Followers for Instagram. And that's kind of what their app images look like if you want to look them up. I know they're on iPhone. I'm not totally sure if they're on Android or not. You might check that, but those two apps are great for that. Number three, you want to follow industry leaders and model after them. So a big teaching point I always like to make to anyone who wants to build a bigger brand and things like that is to follow the biggest brands that are already established. That way you can constantly take notes, find patterns, and implement them in your own brand to just, you know, use what works, to model after what works. You know, success leaves clues, find patterns, and apply them to your own with your own spin on it. So some of the top brands that really do a great job on Instagram are, say, National Geographic and Saturday Night Live, Coca-Cola. They all have millions of followers and tons of engagement. You know, you can go to Instagram and you go to, like, National Geographic or something, and you can look at all these images. You can find the ones that have the most shares. This one, for instance, has 639,000 and then 1,600 plus comments. You know, you can go through here and see how National Geographic does it or other brands and just kind of learn from the best. Number four, make appealing content for the right demographic. In other words, you need to know who you're posting to if you're going to really try to leverage Instagram. And about 53% of Instagram users are all between 18 and 29 years old. So we're talking like young adults. These are the kind of people that are all over Instagram. The rest is divided up, and as the, you know, age brackets get older, the less of them are on Instagram. So you're really focusing on young adults on Instagram. You need to find what they like and go for that. Also, there are about 7% more female users than males on Instagram. So you want to definitely get the ladies involved in your Instagram marketing and make sure that you kind of get all that in there so you're not just posting for one side of the demographic. And just make sure you keep those things in mind. Number five, use images with captions. So a brand that does this really well, and I'm talking about things like quotes, you can do tips, something funny on the image, just a little joke on there or description of what's going on. A brand that does a really good job with this is Founder Magazine. You can see how it's spelled there. They have 855,000 followers, and as you can see, most of their images have text on them. It's like their magazine covers, it's quotes, and things like that. Talking about their latest podcast or their latest cover, but you'll notice that there are a lot of words on their images and they get a lot of shares. So you can learn a lot from Founder Magazine as far as Instagram and posting with captions on your images. That's a great way to get more engagement. Number six, you can use trending hashtags, which is obviously a big part of all Instagram marketing. And there's a few ways you can do this. You can get hashtags from other popular posts, so you can go and find the post from, these top brands like that are in the same industry as you. So if you're talking about business or something, you might go to entrepreneur.com or Business Insider if they have Instagram accounts and check out what their most popular post hashtags are and then use those in your own post. Another thing you can do is use Instagram's Explore feature, which will help you find kind of trending stuff. And you can also go to a website that keeps track of top hashtags, which is top-hashtags.com. And for this example, we want to go to Instagram, so you want to use that one. And it just looks like this. You type it in and you can go to top-hashtags.com. Obviously, you want to go to slash Instagram though, and it'll tell you the latest Instagram. It'll show you the latest Instagram hashtags to look for. So we'll go ahead and go to that. And as you can see, it's hashtag love, hashtag InstaGood, hashtag photo of the day, things like that. You want to keep these in mind if you want to get the most engagement. And next, you want to get your profile right. So if your profile looks like an amateur did it or some kid who doesn't know what he's doing, you're probably not going to get a lot of followers. You're not going to get a lot of people taking you seriously. So if this is for your business brand, use your logo, use your motto, your slogan, or just something that briefly describes your brand and what you're all about. Or if it's branding yourself, maybe you're a consultant, maybe you're a blogger or something like that, you need to put an image of your face just so people can, see your face and recognize you everywhere. Put a little bit about yourself, and obviously you want to always have your link to your main website, whether it's a blog, whether it's a page where they can opt in to your list, whatever your main site page is, you want to use that as well. And next, you want to post with the right frequency and you want to be consistent about it. So the biggest brands on social media always post consistently and they tend to post at the same times each day. That way people look forward to their posts and they know when to get on social media and they know when to expect it. So people will tend to come back that same time each day to see what you posted that day if they like your brand. So top brands on average post on Instagram about 1.5 times per day on average. So, you might post once or twice a day. I wouldn't go more than that. Posting consistently, like I said, it's going to help people expect your content at that time of day. So that means they'll probably get on Instagram that time of day and always check to see what it is that you're posting. So it kind of creates that craving that they have for your content. You also want to have a content theme. So there's a lot of different types of images and videos you can use, a lot of different types of posts, and you can have a motivational quotes, you can do behind the scenes, you can do lifestyle, product showcases, educational tips, all kinds of stuff. What is your brand mainly going to focus on? You might choose two or three of these. So, for instance, if you're going to the Saturday Night Live Instagram account, you'll notice they do a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff and playing jokes on each other and backstage and things like that, or at rehearsals. You'll notice that Founder Magazine, which I showed earlier, they do a lot of quotes. That's one of their main things. You'll see lifestyle images from maybe someone like Tim Ferriss or others. Product showcases you'll see from other brands like Oreo or Coca-Cola do a lot of stuff like that. You can do educational tips where you just give a quick tip, have a cool picture background. There's a lot of different types of posts you can do. And GoPro, which, you know, the cameras, they do like images from their fans. So you'll notice a lot of different people are in these images all the time. And they're doing stuff, they're being active, they're swimming, they're, you know, biking, they're hiking, they're doing stunts, they're rock climbing, they're doing stuff with their GoPro cameras, and they'll use images from their actual fans, so it kind of gives their fans a bigger reason to keep up with their content because they feel like they're a part of it. So that's another cool way to do it. And last but not least, you want to mix images and videos. You don't want to just do one or the other. You can dramatically increase engagement by using videos. Like I mentioned, GoPro, they do crowdsource videos and images, so you can get them involved and get them to post different things for you. And like I said, you can go to their profile and check out all their stuff, see kind of what really is popular. And a lot of it is simple. It's like somebody was at a sunset and captured it on the GoPro, and they'll post that and it'll go viral. So just mix it up, use videos and images, know what kind of theme you're going to use for your post, and, you know, follow the rest of these tips and you'll do a lot better on Instagram. You'll get a lot more followers, you'll get a lot more traffic to your website, you'll get a lot more engagement, and I'm sure your business will really pick up from it. So if you got something from this video, if you feel like you learned something that you can use, don't forget to like it and subscribe so I can create more great videos like this for you to help you out. If you want to mention something that I might have missed in the video about Instagram marketing, or you want to just let me know what you thought about the video, you can let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. And if you want to contact me directly, if you want to write for me, if you want to see some in-depth blog posts on this kind of stuff, or get some actual courses and tools that will help you, you can go to selfmadesuccess.com. Other than that, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you have a great day.